Hey, Andrew. We are being led tonight by our confirmation class. These are some of just the brightest, most thoughtful kids that I have gotten to work with, and I'm so proud to share them with all of you tonight. And parents and mentors, if you are here, it's just going to be such a treat for you guys to see the way that these kids are already growing in their faith and their ability to express their faith. So when we started putting together this worship service, we talked about what worship is and why we worship. And then we broke up into groups, and these kids put together a worship service, and I literally did nothing to help them. So it's really a testament to how they've grown and how God's been working in their life this far. So it's really exciting. And that was Celine Crenshaw on the organ, which is pretty cool too.
This is the season of holy waiting.
We wait for the one whose word is set at his coming.
We watch for the day when all who mourn will know gladness and praise.
We wait while the dawning light appears on the horizon.
Come, let us walk in the light of God.
Ignite all families with the spirit of light and love. May the grace
prophet Isaiah, chapter 60, verses 1 through 2 and 18 through 19. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord rises upon you. See, darkness covers the earth, and thick darkness is over the peoples, but the Lord rises upon you, and his glory appears over you. No longer will violence be heard in your land, nor ruin or destruction within your borders, but you will call your walls salvation and your gates praise. The sun will no more be your light by day, nor will the brightness of the moon shine on you, for the Lord will be your everlasting light, and your God will be your glory.
Good evening, and of course, Merry Christmas. Unfortunately, we live in a world today filled with fear and violence. There are shootings, bombings, and different extremist groups in the world. This leaves everyone in a constant state of fear and anguish. However, these passages show us the peace that the Lord provides us, the salvation Christ yields. No longer will violence be heard in your land. Keep in mind, Isaiah is spreading the good news of Christ's coming when he says this. He reaffirms that Christ will be the world's salvation. He will wipe the world of hatred and violence. Isaiah also describes the world as covered in darkness. As Isaiah chapter 60, verse 2 reads, "For behold, darkness shall cover the earth, and thick darkness is over the peoples. But the Lord will arise you, and his glory will be seen upon you." Here, Isaiah depicts the world as covered in darkness. He proceeds to explain that the Lord will bring us from the darkness of the world to his light and glory. Christ's arrival will be the salvation that will wipe the world of its darkness. He will bring peace among people, and will arise us from the murkiness of this world. In addition, in verse 19, Isaiah describes that the Lord will be our everlasting light. In this way, Isaiah reassures that Christ's coming will brighten the world of its darkness. So, during this Advent season, we need to remember God's arrival is the salvation that will protect us from the world's terrors. In the coming week, let God's everlasting light shine upon all of us, and bring peace to the world.
So as they're moving around, we're about to sing a song that has been important to the ministry with youth at this church for a long time, as well as many other places. It's a song called Sanctuary. Aren't they beautiful? Aren't they so great? No, it can't even fit. So this is a song called Sanctuary, and it's a really beautiful piece in it. Do you want to play it?
Am I supposed to?
You don't have to.
Oh, good.
They're great a cappella.
Fine.
But so this is a really beautiful piece to kind of center on. And it's a great way that we all prepare to worship God in the world, not just when we're together in a place of worship, but it's saying, God, prepare me to live for you when I'm here and when I'm not here. And so we're going to share that with you guys now, and we'll sing it twice, and if you catch on, we'll just keep singing it a couple times. That's usually how this song kind of goes. Sound good?
For prepare me to be a sanctuary, pure and holy, tried and true, with thanksgiving, I'll be a living sanctuary for you.
Advent season and every day to be able to feel your love.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our world can indeed be a dark and murky place. But God's light shines, and this meal, this table that we get to gather around, this is a sign of that light in the world. And God invites all of us, near and far from him, to join him and one another at this table, to be restored and reminded of that light that indeed shines. Let's pray. God, we thank you for the mystery of this table, for the ways that you offer yourself to us in bread and juice. We ask that you would nourish us with this meal. Remind us that your strength and your power and your light goes with us always. Let this meal be a blessing to our bodies and send us out here strong and renewed people. And we pray this in your son's name. On the night that Jesus was betrayed, he was having dinner with all of his friends. And after they had shared a meal together, Jesus took bread. And after giving thanks to God, he broke it. And he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, Jesus took the cup, saying, "This cup is the new covenant, sealed in my blood, shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. Every time you drink it, do this in remembrance of me." Friends, every time we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the saving death of our risen Lord until he comes. These are the gifts of God for all of you, the people of God. Thanks be to God. All things are ready. We're going to serve communion by intinction, which means we're going to come up through the center aisles. You're going to rip off a piece of bread. We have gluten-free bread on this tray, and then we have a loaf of bread here. And I always like to remind people, whenever you get to take a piece of bread, take much more than you think you deserve, because that is how God offers himself to you. So we'll take the bread that way, and then you dip it in the cup, and then you get to taste and eat this delicious meal that we're offered. Andrew's going to usher you.
Thank you.